and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they will give him: the Lord our justice. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have become near by blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of the enmity through his flesh, abolishing the law with its commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in place of the two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both with God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we were both have access to one Spirit, to the Father, the word of the Lord.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off in the boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord. In our day and age, our lives are filled with noise all the time, aren't they? Did you have your radio on the car while you were coming here? Huh? How many were on their cell phone before they got in church, or even after you got into church, right? There's always something going on. There's always somebody talking. There's always something going on TV or cable. It's rare sometimes when, you know, in my last parish when I visited people, especially the old ones, you know, they couldn't hear it worth a darn anyways. But the TV was on, the radio was on, and I'm trying to talk too and hear them, you know? But we're so used to having lots of stuff going on that we forget the message of the gospel, which is quiet and very clear, but very loving. You know, if we don't quiet down, we miss what's going on. If we don't step back, we miss what's happened. If we don't look back, we forget how to look forward with grace and dignity. Our readings come to us today and teach us that Jesus, even though he's tired, he's a superhuman, isn't he? Even though he's dead tired, he wants to teach and be with his people. God's grace never ends. God is bigger than us. His grace never ends. But he says they're like sheep without a shepherd. You know, and the sheep learn somebody's voice. They learn to listen to one voice, and probably a dog too, you know? But they learn to listen to one voice and nobody else's. And we listen to everybody else's voice. But how often do we listen to the voice of the Lord working in our lives? Because the voice of the Lord gives us direction, it gives us peace, and the wonderful thing about it, it forces us to choose whether to be bad or to be good. The real voice of God is never saying, "You know it all, my neighbor knows it all, the commentator on TV, radio, the internet, or TikTok knows it all." It says, "God knows it all." And that's a strange little phenomenon, isn't it? But people flock to hear the truth. People flock because it was the first time in history that people had a chance to hear what God would do. They had a chance to be close to God. They had a chance to become one with God. They had a chance to do the same work the disciples do. We come here today and we start that practice of the human journey, the Christian journey. Because remember, the Christian journey is coming in and going out into the world. It can't be just one. We not only come to the Lord, but we go out into the world to be his new disciples, just like the apostles, to do his great work. Sometimes we forget that. But what do we have to do? It's a summer day. It's a beautiful day. I'm sure a few of you will be on your deck tonight, maybe with a cocktail or two. But you can still relax and step back, can't you? And say, "Thank you, God, for this wonderful day." Part of life is stepping back and finding the time each day to hear quiet. Quiet is very loud. I'm sure some of our young ones here, you know, they know every song on the radio from Taylor Swift, right? The whole catalog. But can they be quiet for 5 minutes, the space of a song. Because in being quiet, we have to confront ourselves. Who am I? What did I do? What do I want to be? And the big one, what did I get wrong and how do I make it right? Every time we step back, God enters into us and strips away all of the stuff of society, all the stuff that make us think we're better than others. No clothes, no style, no jewelry, no nothing, just you and God. And when we step back, God says, I like you just as you are. And once we quiet, then the process of God starts working. If God loves us so, there's a feeling that we want to tap into. There's an experience that we want to continue. And we'll soon find ourselves living a life pleasing to God. For when we quiet down, we know God wants me. God loves me. God forgives me. And we want to go forth and make him proud. We come to God because we need that strength for the journey. Who else gives us that strength? The weight of the world is on a lot of people, isn't it? But the strength of the Lord is there. And then we're like the disciples. Jesus has gathered his people together, and they went out and did their wonders and miracles, and now they got to come and reflect. But they went out into the world to do what is right and just and good. They invited other people in. They said, you don't have to be perfect, but God will figure this out. Come together. Come and realize the goodness of God. What do we need to do in our day and age, I think, is just find a time every day where you can really listen to God. You got an egg timer? Oh, you got a watch that's electronic? 2 minutes. Try it. See if you last 2 minutes. 2 minutes of quiet with the Lord. See if you can do it. And then 5 minutes, 10 minutes. It doesn't have to be a long time. But God is invited into our lives by silence. You know why? It ain't music. It ain't TikTok. It ain't somebody else's opinion. It ain't any noise. It's the voice of God. And he's very quiet because he works very deeply in us. Find a time to be quiet. Secondly, be thankful then. Be thankful when you hear the voice of the Lord, because he kind of tells us what's right, what's wrong, who to listen to, who not to listen to, doesn't he? He says, my way is the best way. And then thirdly, check yourself out. Check yourself out. In the noise of the world, how much time did you really spend with God today, besides Mass? It's good that you come to Mass. But what about the rest of the day? How much time did you spend with him? Did you spend time on MSNBC or CNN, watching a movie, playing your records, playing your TikTok on your video? What was it? How much time do you really spend with the Lord outside of worship? Because we need to walk with God. And finally, read his word. Because it gives us direction, doesn't it? The world is going to tell you it's okay to hate. The world is going to tell you it's okay to kick somebody out. The world is going to tell you somebody's no good. The world is going to say something that's going to bring darkness into the world. We need the gospel that says, love God, love your neighbor as yourself. Or to put it in the Jewish words, do not do to another what you would detest being done to you. Boy, that's a real powerful one, isn't it? Different way of looking at life. Don't do to another what you would detest being done to you. It really is a checkpoint. God is good. God is always good. And he wants us to be the people that hear his voice and take a rest. Come to the Lord, get your rest. Go forth and do good. Sometimes it's just a good word. Sometimes it's patience. Sometimes it's peace. Sometimes it's a hello. Sometimes it's a real hand and heart working for the poor. But whatever it is, do good and come back to the Lord and say thank you. And the Lord will say, well done, good and faithful servant of the Lord. Let us stand and proclaim our faith. I believe it. Gathered together as God's holy people, let's present to him the prayers of this church.
Let us pray for the church. God of justice and mercy, may Jesus always be our peace, reconciling us to you and to one another. Give us leaders and shepherds modeled after your own heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for peace. Good Shepherd, break down the walls of division in every land and nation, especially in places where hostility stretches back for generations. Comfort refugees and the victims of violence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and those in need of rest and care. Gather to yourself those who walk in the dark valleys of sickness, frailty, or suffering. Lord, strengthen and comfort them, especially Jennifer Snyder, Joe Carr, Valerie Dykeman, and all who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. Eternal Shepherd, may your goodness and kindness lead our loved ones into your home forever, especially John Courtney, Edward Moran, Ramon J. Cuchera, and Dolores Zimmer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those in the care of Mother Earth and for those who till the soil. Lord of creation, help us to be faithful stewards of all that you have entrusted to us. Send rains to the land and bless farmers, migrant workers, and all who put food on our tables. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us call to mind our own personal needs in a moment of silence. Good Shepherd, fill us with your compassion for the needs of others. Through these summer days, help us find rest in you. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Gracious Father, you gave us your Son so that we might see you and know you and love you all the more. Help us today and every day to hear your voice so that we might know your great love and then go forward to give your love to one another. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may always be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Alan, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let's pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Although Father Jim is still on vacation this weekend, he wanted to share some good news with our community. Beginning next month, Father Mike Taiba, who made a short visit with us this last summer, will be assigned here at St. Joseph Parish. We are happy to welcome Father Mark, who will be moving into the rectory in the next couple of weeks and begin his ministry here. We are unaware of any other plans for additional changes to our current clergy staff. A heartfelt thank you to all families who have pledged to this year's CSA campaign. To date, we have achieved 79% of our goal with 532 families pledging a total of $219,442. Please check The Voice or our website for the upcoming events and opportunities, including an exhibit of Eucharistic miracles in Marion Hall is available for your viewing through this Sunday and today. And next weekend, we celebrate World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. We encourage you to bring your grandparents and senior family members and friends to any of our weekend masses where they will receive a special blessing.
And the Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.